To thee, O Lord, I lift up my soul. O my God, in thee I trust. Do not let me be ashamed. Do not let my enemies exult over me. Indeed, none of those who wait for thee will be ashamed. Those who deal treacherously without cause will be ashamed. Make me know thy ways, O Lord. Teach me thy paths. Lead me in thy truth and teach me. For thou art the God of my salvation. For thee I wait all the day. Remember, O Lord, thy compassion and thy loving kindnesses. For they have been from of old. Do not remember the sins of my youth or my transgressions. According to thy loving kindnesses, remember thou me for thy goodness' sake, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord. Therefore, he instructs sinners in the way. He leads the humble in justice, and he teaches the humble his way. All the paths of the Lord are loving kindness and truth to those who keep his covenant and his testimonies. For thy name's sake, O Lord, pardon my iniquity, for it is great. Who is the man who fears the Lord? He will instruct him in the way he should choose. His soul will abide in prosperity, and his descendants will inherit the land. The secret of the Lord is for those who fear him, and he will make them know his covenant. His eyes are continually toward the Lord, for he will pluck my feet out of the net. Turn to me and be gracious to me, for I am lonely and afflicted. The troubles of my heart are enlarged. Bring me out of my distresses. Look upon my affliction and my trouble, and forgive all my sins. Look upon my enemies, for they are many, and they hate me with violent hatred. Guard my soul and deliver me. Do not let me be ashamed, for I take refuge in thee. Let integrity and uprightness preserve me. For I wait for thee. Redeem Israel, O God, out of his troubles. Psalms 25:1-22. Secrets. What is the sign of a friend? That he tells you secret sorrows? No, that he tells you secret joys. Many will confide to you their secret sorrows, but the last mark of intimacy is to confide secret joys. Have you ever let God tell us any of his secret joys? Or are you telling God our secrets so continually that we leave no room for him to talk to us? At the beginning of our Christian life, we are full of requests to God. Then we find out that God wants to get us into relationship with himself. We find out God wants to get us in touch with his purposes. Are we so wedded to Jesus Christ's idea of prayer, your will be done, that we catch the secrets of God? The things that make God dear to us are not so much his great big blessings as the tiny things, because they show his amazing intimacy with us. He knows every detail of our individual lives. He knows all our secrets.